Ladies and gentlemen, Her Majesty's Lord Lieutenant for West Yorkshire. Senior partners, the Cadets, who operate slightly differently, but still receive support.
Recently, you'll have seen in the press lots of statements about cadets is good, lots of things happening with government reviews. The positive thing that comes out of all of that, it doesn't matter which colour party or who you're talking to, there seems to be genuine support for cadets. And therefore, it's a good time to be involved and things can only move forward in a positive way. So that's an encouraging note for me, and I've most probably stolen everybody else's clothes that they want to say later on, but as I've said to the mayor of Wakefield, if you're on first, you get on first and you can say it and nobody else can do it, can they? Finally, I just have to thank you, ma'am, Lord Mayor's Worship, ladies and gentlemen, for coming, supporting the evening, and you'll see the quality of the young people that I've been talking about in their presentations. I'm obliged to you all. Thank you very much for your attention.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to meet the three cadets who are being made Lord Lieutenant cadets tonight. We'll be coming in order of precedence, which is Navy, Army, Air Force. Agree with it, that's the way it is. I'm hoping these will end up out there somewhere, because our first cadet, representing the Sea Cadet Corps and the Royal Navy. Where are you, Mr. Wood? Should be there somewhere. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the Sea Cadet Corps and the Royal Navy, please welcome Petty Officer Cadet Peter Wood. Geographically, they're spread across the whole of the RFC area, from Richmond to Sheffield and Cleethorpes to Skipton, including all the major towns and all the major cities. In many locations, they are the only uniformed presence in their town or their area. You get to a fantastic range of activities throughout the year, and I could stand here and talk for hours about what they do. But let's take a look at the sorts of stuff they've been up to in the past 12 months. Excelled in their work and completed the majority of the training. They will have the opportunity to attend the Lord Lieutenant at civic functions and military occasions, which in previous years have included royal visits. Prior to their appointment as Lord Lieutenant's cadets, they have the opportunity to tell you about themselves. This is the bit they're dreading. And what they've gained during the membership of the cadet unit, and what they can do to help the local area and you and indeed they are part of. Our first presentation tonight is from the Sea Cadet Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Petty Officer Cadet Peter.
Good evening, Lord Lieutenant, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I am Petty Officer Cadet Wood, and I'm going to show you a brief PowerPoint about my time in Sea Cadets so far. I joined Sea Cadets on the 9th of January 2008, the day before my 12th birthday. My first weekend in Sea Cadets was a drill training weekend held at TSRR in Bradford. I learnt the basics of drill and its purposes. From here, I went on to taking charge of the squad, to being in the guard, and finally, commanding the guard. Also, I have participated in drill competitions at district and area level. At our last unit inspection, I had the role of being the unit parade commander. I have also recently returned from my cadet drill instructor's course. After learning the basics of drill, I went on to participate in various parades. The three main parades I attend each year are Remembrance Day, Armed Forces Day, and Trafalgar Parade. For the last 3 years, a Remembrance Sunday parade, I have represented the unit as standard bearer. This year I will be attending the National Trafalgar Parade in London. In order for the Sea Cadets to operate, we need to raise funds to cover essential costs such as maintenance and the utilities of the building. We also fundraise for the Alexander Rose Charity and the Royal British Legion. We go about raising such funds by bagpacking at local supermarkets, and each year I help with the poppy appeal. Throughout my time in Sea Cadets, I've been involved in many competitions. These include drill, rowing, sailing and football. For the competitions, there are three levels. These are district, area and national. In drill, I started off part of a cull party of five. I was a standard bearer. From there, I went on to being in charge of the cull party. This previous year, we won district and ranked third out of 10 at area. Rowing. 2 years ago, I was part of the unit rowing team for the open boys category, 12 to 18 year olds. Unfortunately, we were beaten at district. Sailing. This year, I participated in area sailing for the first time and came fourth out of six as part of a crew of two in the year 2000. Football. 2 years running, I have been the goalkeeper in the boys' football team for Bradford, one of which we won district, but I was unable to attend the area competition. While being in cadets, I have attended many courses. I have been to Holyhead in Anglesey, Eastern Area Boat Station for Thrapston, the Naval Base for Caledonia, Britannia Royal Naval College at Dartmouth. I've gained many qualifications, ranging from sailing and windsurfing to first aid and ropework and rigging. Also, I completed my Bronze Duke of Edinburgh Award. Although I did not complete it through cadets, I'm still able to wear the badge on my uniform. Additionally to this, I have attended the Royal British Legion Standard Bearer Course. The highlight of my Sea Cadet career so far was when earlier this year I was selected to go to Britannia Royal Naval College at Dartmouth, where I acquired my competent crew in yachting. Whilst at the establishment, I met the Second Sea Lord, Vice Admiral Sir Charles Montgomery. Also, when I was at Dartmouth, I experienced a mess dinner with officers from the college. The week I spent at the college acts as preparation for the future, because my intention is to go on to join the Royal Navy as an officer. I would like to thank you for your time. I hope you have enjoyed the presentation.
Ladies and gentlemen, our second speaker tonight, representing the Army Air Force, is Cadets Company Sergeant Major Sergeant Dowdeswell.
Lord-Lieutenant and honoured guests, I'm Company Sergeant Major Jake Dowdeswell. I'm 17 years old, I'm Yeadon Sergeant C Company, Yorkshire North and West. Before I start, I've got a very bad cold, so if you start coughing, please bear with me. Okay, I won't be down. My early years of cadets. I've been a cadet now for 4.5 years. The reason I joined is because since the age of about 6, I've wanted to join the army. I never wanted to do anything else as a kid, I never wanted to be a footballer, anything like that. I always wanted to go in the army, so the cadets seemed like the best thing for me. At the age of 14, I took part in my first competition with cadets, which was a competition called Champion Company. Luckily that year we actually won it, and I remember being so delighted. Luckily after that, I was picked to be part of the Colts Canada team, which is an absolute honour. It's a very prestigious event for my battalion and the whole North actual Army cadets. So yeah, there's pictures of me taking part in both competitions. SCRC was my first ever major course. It stands for the Senior Cadet Instructors course. This really helped me to become the actual leader. It first taught me my principles of being a leader, a good role model, all those sort of things. So it's a perfect foundation for my cadet career. So this course really, I'd say, started it all off for me big time. Merlin Carter. Merlin Carter, which was a 4-star Philcraft course, was absolutely excellent. I learned so many new skills about Philcraft, which was absolutely perfect for me because that's my favourite subject in cadets. So yeah, it was a massive eye-opener for me to see what it's like to actually do a lot of military things as well, because we did a few exercises, fighting built-up areas, which I thoroughly enjoyed, and luckily I was picked to be the section commander as well. Now, as you can see, I'm sort of bossing people about the combat area, so yeah, I really, really enjoyed that. Challenger Company. A Challenger Company is a course which is run by the cadets. It's basically a junior annual camp which is all run by cadets. Only the adults oversee, and they only get involved unless they absolutely have to, basically. Every cadet has a rank and an appointment while they're on the course. I was a platoon commander, which was absolutely brilliant for me, a really good experience, as I remember becoming an officer in the army. It was a massive eye-opener to see what it was like to be a platoon commander. And I've got to say, it was hard work. But I had an excellent time and I had the best of the two throughout the course, so I was really, really happy with that. My second best achievement would have to be the Nesliff Cadet Leadership Course, which actually involves Sea Cadets, Air Cadets and Army Cadets and the Combined Cadets as well. So it's an overall course. Luckily, I was picked to be the platoon commander for my platoon. I was the top of the platoon. So I got to be a platoon commander on the last day of the course, where I had to plan a whole attack myself, give a full orders briefing, and actually completely mission all on my own without any help whatsoever. I was assessed on everything I did as the platoon commander through the whole day of the exercise, and luckily I came second overall. I was really, really happy with myself, and that was a massive eye-opener to see what it was like to be a platoon commander in a combat situation, as you would say. Yeah, it was an excellent experience, one I'll never forget. We did many things on the course as well, such as like hostage situations, medical hazard acts, things I'll never forget, things I'll take on with me now into the army. So it was an excellent course. My biggest achievement so far would have to be the Rocky Mountain Cadet Leadership Course, where I went to Canada on the Cadet Exchange. Basically, only 12 cadets from all of Britain were picked, including Army Cadets and the Combined Cadets. So I was lucky enough to be picked to go on that course. I spent all this summer there, 6 weeks long, Yeah, I had an absolutely excellent time. I took part in kayaking, rock climbing, glacier walking, sorted two mountains while I was there, horse riding up a mountain, that was interesting. Lots of other excellent things. I learned so many things that will stay with me for the future. Luckily, as well, as you see in the picture, there I am. I had a parade position on the final parade there. Luckily, I got to march my platoon onto the parade square. I was the platoon sergeant, which was an absolute honour considering we were the foreigners going over there. There was only 12 of us competing against 150 Canadian cadets, so that was an absolute honour and my biggest achievement so far, I'd say. And there's a picture. I had to put this picture on it because the excellent cakes he made. It was absolutely brilliant. I couldn't believe it when I saw it. I had to put that on there. And there's the future. I'm currently at sixth form doing A levels. I'm hoping to go on to Sandhurst and become an officer in the parachute regiment, hopefully. While I'm at university, I'm hoping to join the 4th Barrier Unit in Pudsey. Do a year there as a soldier and hopefully get a short-term commission while I'm there. Also going to join the OTC Leeds, which would be a really, really good experience. But yeah, that's the plan. Parachute regiment, hopefully, in Sandhurst. A lot of the pubs, so yeah. But my future for the rest of the cadets, next month I'm taking part in the Master Cadet course, which is the highest course that Army Cadet can do, which is an absolute honour. I really can't wait for that. But just before that, next week, I'm in the course kind of final, which I can guarantee my company staff, we're out here then. We are going to win. Okay, we are going to win that. I bring that up. I guarantee that. So I'd just like to say thank you very much to Colonel Rendon, Commandant of the Yorkshire North and West. Major Lomas, my OC. Lieutenant Smith, who is unfortunately my training officer. Lieutenant Creed, my own detachment commander, thank you very much. Sergeant Moore, my current detachment commander, cheers. All the staff at Yorkshire North and West, but mainly Seagull and the staff, got all that in there. And of course, all my family, thank you for supporting me for all these years. Thank you very much.
Experiencing my time as the Air Cadets is a squadron one weekend at Squirrelwood in Doncaster. We did field craft and leadership exercises, and this is one of the first times I've learnt teamwork skills, and probably the main reason I stayed near ATC all those years ago. As a squadron, we support our local community and military charities such as the RAF Association throughout the year. It's an opportunity for cadets to raise funds for those who are less fortunate than ourselves. At 2388, we pride ourselves on our participation in these events. During my time at school, I was quite a quiet person who kept her head down and followed the crowd. My squadron staff saw in something that others did not. They gave me responsibilities and pushed me beyond my limits. This gave me the opportunity to push myself and helped me achieve things I never would have imagined. And it has helped me become the best I can be beyond the ATM. Despite the fact I don't like sport with passion, I am represented with my squadron and wing at various sports, such as hockey, volleyball, athletics, cross country, archery and swimming. The Air Cadets has given me the opportunity to fly in numerous RAF aircraft and participate in opportunity flights, in powered aircraft and gliders. This is a chance I would not have got if I did not join the ATC. I've also been given opportunities to lead others and help manage the squadron and its activities. My responsibilities have included sport, drill and discipline, and intake. Now I'm an adult cadet, I am treated with the same level of respect as any member of staff. I am continually challenged and given responsibilities. My title squadron is NCO Training Air, so I am involved with the academic training within my squadron. This includes the BTEC awards, the classification exams, and organising the training programmes. I organised an extra week ago on NCO courses and helped train them on junior NCOs. In the near future, I have got my cadet warrants aboard, and if successful, it's the highest rank I can achieve as a cadet. I am finishing my A levels and hope to improve my maths AS grade to a B and achieve my target of giving 3 subjects to 8 stars. My next step in education is to attend university and do a business economics degree. I then plan to progress into a financial or management career. I'd like to thank my family for supporting me in getting up at ridiculous times on Sunday mornings to take cadets. I'd also like to thank my squadron staff for the amazing opportunities I have been given and their continued support since I joined.
Lord-Lieutenant, Sergeant Dowdeswell, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening. I think we have to agree that it is not an easy thing to stand up in front of such a high-powered audience of senior officers, Lord Mayors and Lord Lieutenant. Ladies and gentlemen, our three Lord Lieutenants cadets. Peter Wood. Peter, come from the centre place. If I could ask Powers Officer Bulmer to assist the Lord Lieutenant with the certificates, please. And before we do this, to read the citation. behalf of the Sea Cadet Corps, we'd like to welcome Officer Commanding TSRO of Bradford Sea Cadet Corps, Lieutenant Lindbergh.
Qualified in canoeing, powerboating, windsurfing and sailing. He is soon to attend the rowing instructor's course. On land, he is qualified in communications, mechanical engineering, seamanship, roadwork and rigging, as well as being a first aid qualified cadet and a cadet drill instructor. Peter is a senior cadet in the unit and an excellent role model who shows determined leadership qualities, and his position is the main link between the cadets and me and my staff, and is well respected by all who meet him. Peter will represent the Sea Cadet Corps proudly as a Lord Lieutenant's Cadet.
Sergeant Major Dowdeswell is a member of the Yeadon Detachment and is very committed to his company and other detachments. He leads from the front and has always been involved in the Colts County competition. As a sportsman, he has represented his detachment at county, regional and national level. He has completed his Bronze DMV award and is well on the way to silver, as well as completing the Senior Cadet Instructor's Cadre. This, with four annual camps under his belt, made him an experienced and dedicated Army cadet. Jake is a trustworthy and conscientious cadet, making him an excellent role model. He hopes to join the Parachute Regiment as an officer. He will make an excellent ambassador for the Army Cadet Force as Lord Lieutenant Cadet. Kirsty Lightfoot has been an air cadet for 2388 Squadron, the air training corps, since 2007. And in that time, she has excelled in every challenge the organisation has to offer. Kirsty has achieved a Bronze and Silver Duke of Edinburgh Award and is well on the way to achieving her goal. Her BTEC in Aviation Studies, her Cadet Method of Instruction course. She has participated in numerous sporting and adventure training activities at camps at RAF stations and the Air Cadet National Adventure Training. It was not long before we started to realise that Kirsty was not just your average cadet. Her attendance has always been 100% since the day she joined, right up to now, and she has always endeavoured to attend every weekend activity she can. She has earned the annual award as best cadet on more than one occasion. Her no-nonsense attitude and work ethic has earned Kirsty many accolades. She was awarded the squadron's best NCO 3 times, has won the Royal Air Force Association Battle of Britain Trophy for charity on numerous occasions, and has recently been awarded a certificate of good service from the Commandant Air Cadets. As a cadet NCO, Kirsty has always been a leader of the other cadets. She's commanded the squadron's intake flight and has been responsible for inducting and training new cadets, and was pivotal in helping me as OC design, initiate and manage the current squadron's flight system and inter-flight competition, which has made massive impacts on the squadron over recent years. Not only is Kirsty a high flyer with the cadets, but she was an A-star pupil at GCSE and has continued this level of academic excellence through her A-level qualifications. Since her 16th birthday, Kirsty has always worked part-time job during the days and weekends and every day during the school holidays. The only disruption to this is when she attends cadet activities. There are often times when she will take the earlier or later shift and arrive at cadet activities and get changed from her work uniform into her ATC one. Over the last 3 months, the squadron has been running on one member of uniform staff. Flight Sergeant Lightfoot stepped up and supported the unit 110%. She took on the role of squadron training officer, where she was responsible for ensuring all the cadets have the opportunity to achieve their BTECs, as well as overseeing the squadron's induction programme, running the new auto-learning exam system. We recently had a visit from the wing point of contact officer for BARDA, and he received training from Kirsty there on how to run the system, so he could tell the other squadrons within the wing. Writing the squadron training programme and liaising with the Cadet Vocational Qualifications Organisation officer. This has resulted in the highest number of enrolments public service BTEC we have ever had. Kirsty has proven to all who know her within the ACO that despite being initially very quiet and very shy when you first meet her, she's professional, hard-working, committed, as well as being an inspirational leader and excellent example to the cadets below her. She's quite simply the finest example of youth today.
Person, and it seems to me you fit so much into your days, every day of your life, that you're going to go places. At the weekend, I read the full citations, and because they were so impressive, I just wanted to read you one or two of the things about these fine three people. Not the things they've done, but the people that they are. Leads from the front, inspires others, trustworthy, conscientious, highly professional, has good communication skills, shows determined leadership, judges time well, just said, combining school work, part-time work and other activities effectively together. Fundraising, you saw reference to that in 2 cases. Efficiency, community service, outstanding cadet comes again and again, confident, articulate, intelligent, an excellent ambassador. We live in a time where too many children, too many young people, I'm sorry, are not encouraged to maximise on their skills, just rather to waste their time and perhaps to get up to no good at all. And these are the sort of people who are role models for all the rest of our society. It's just such a privilege to meet three people who are as fine and splendid as this. I shall be using you a bit during the following year. I mean, Remembrance Sunday is coming up pretty soon, and I hope one of you will come to meet with me to, I'm going to Leeds this year. The Vice Lord Lieutenant is going to Bradford, and I have a very senior and much respected Deputy Lieutenant going to Wakefield. So I hope that one of you will accompany each of the three of us. And there will be other engagements. They're not going to get in the way of your academic work or your work with the cadets, but I would like to be able to, particularly during the odd weekend, to ask you to come out with me and to accompany me to things. Many congratulations, and I'm just, again, so proud to have you as my cadets. Well done this evening.
To make a couple of additional presentations this evening, which he's very graciously agreed to do. The presentations are the Defence Council Letter of Appreciation, which is probably one of the highest awards that a member of the Air Cadets or any of the cadet forces can achieve. It's one below an MBE, and I'm absolutely delighted this evening that we have two recipients of such a prestigious award, in addition to the number 22 group commendation as well. These two individuals have given a lifetime of service to the cadet organisation. In fact, both of them have served in the organisation longer than I've been on this earth, which kind of puts it in context. The two individuals are an exemplary adaptation of what a good member of staff, and they've given their time tirelessly to the organisation. So I've been very grateful indeed, Mark, if you do the presentations this evening. The first one is to Flight Lieutenant Brian Wood, retired from the NCO. And when the Lord Lieutenant says that she also becomes nervous when she has to stand and do a presentation. I can assure you, I feel exactly the same way. But what amazed me this evening was the way in which they conducted themselves in a very professional manner, with confidence and convinced I did not have at their age. So you know, credit to all of them. I absolutely know that the Lord Lieutenant will use them well and wisely in the next 12 months, and I know they're going to have an amazing time and they'll see things and experiences that we wouldn't ordinarily get. And, you know, Mark, thank you very much indeed for doing that for us. The cadet organisation, whether or not they're in the Army Cadets, Sea Cadets, or the Indeed Air Training Corps, are probably the best youth organisations we've got in the United Kingdom, if not the world. And it never ceases to amaze me, in my short time of 20 years in the organisation, that the young cadets have come through the doors at 13 and leave as better citizens. Many go on to the armed services, and I'm delighted that they do so. Many go into civilian life, and they are better citizens for being part of this organisation. The other aspect, when I go around the schools, you can always spot the cadets. They're the smart ones, they're the ones who will always shine, and I'm particularly proud of being a part of the organisation. As was said earlier, the buildings and the infrastructure is very kindly looked after by the RFCA, and I'd like tonight to give a particular tribute to the Chief Executive and to Lieutenant Colonel Bleasdale, who have really supported not just the Air Cadets but also the other two youth organisations. We're in now the Cadet Centre, and we've had a bit of a makeover with the Activity Centre. So a lot of what I hope you'll enjoy and see this evening has been funded by the RFCA, and we're eternally grateful for doing that. Thank you very much, sir. That's all I really want to say this evening, apart from I really do hope that you enjoy the rest of the evening. I hope you share the time with the three cadets, who it's a very, very proud moment for them. And also, you know, a huge thank to the volunteers of all the three services who do give their time tirelessly in very challenging times. I'd also like to thank Arthur, media officer this evening, for his wit and humour that we've come to love over the years. But thank you very much, Mike, for organising the evening as well. And that's really all I wish to say this evening, apart from I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening and a safe journey home. Thank you very much.
So apart from that, it just is left for me to say, on behalf of our three Lord Lieutenant's cadets, it's good night from them, and it's good night from them.